Good morning, good morning. Happy Monday to you. Good morning, good morning. Heartbeat Andrea. Heartbeat Juanita, good morning. Hey, Heartbeat Carolyn. Good morning to you guys. Hope you had a great weekend. Hope you got a lot of rest last night. Hey, Heartbeat Tanya, good morning, good morning. Hey, Heartbeat Aaliyah, good morning to you guys. Good morning, good morning. Hey, Heartbeat Queen O, good morning. Hey, Heartbeat Doris, good morning. Marvelous Monday to you too, Heartbeat Andrea. Good morning, good morning, good morning. We are starting another week. Hey, Heartbeat Alicia, Heartbeat DJ. Hey, Heartbeat Sherry, good morning. Hey, Heartbeat Belinda, Heartbeat Smitty, Heartbeat Anita, Heartbeat Rachelle, good morning, good morning, good morning to you guys. Well, let's get started here. I am Regina Banks, your GPS to wholeness. Welcome to the Gathering of Hearts. And this morning, your daily dosage is this: pass the salt and tame your tongue. Pass the salt and tame your tongue. And so, you know, we've been talking about I'm addicted to the abundant life, and being addicted to the abundant life includes forgiveness. And then we talked about look again to be reminded of what God has already told us. Hey, Heartbeat Elaine, Heartbeat Donald, Heartbeat Big Mike, what's going on this morning? And we've been reminded about looking again. And so in thinking of all of that and being addicted to the abundant life, we've got to watch what comes out of our mouths, because we have the power, life and death is in the power of our tongue. And so we've got to watch what we say out of our mouths. You know, we can't be praising God one day and confessing this and confessing that and believing God for things and then turn around in the next sentence and curse everything that you've already said. And so I want you guys to start to be more conscientious of what you're saying out of your mouth. Amen. What you're saying out of your mouth. And so Matthew 5:13, the Message version says this: let me tell you why you are here. You're here to be salt seasoning that brings out the God flavors on this earth. If you lose your saltiness, how will people taste godliness? You've lost your usefulness and will end up in the garbage. And so it's saying that we ought to be the salt of the earth. And so if there's anybody on here that likes to cook, like I do, you know that the perfect seasonings make the perfect dish, right? You put too much salt or something in it, it's going to jack the whole dish up. Well, that's the same thing with us, with our words. If we don't use salt as seasoning to season our words, we could mess somebody's life up. We could be a bad representation of Christ. And he's saying, don't you know why you're here? You're here to be the seasoning of the earth. You're here to bring out the God flavors on this earth, which means we should be sprinkling peace. We should be sprinkling joy. We should be sprinkling love. We should be sprinkling meekness. We should be sprinkling temperance or self-control. We're here to shake the seasonings of God on this earth. So we have a responsibility when we open up our mouths to only say what God says. We've got to learn how to tame the tongue. You don't have to say everything that's on your mind. You don't have to give your two cents all the time. So he says that when you're not speaking what he says, when you're not sprinkling seasonings of God flavors on this earth, he says you're useless. It's like the garbage. Might as well throw you out, because you're down here on earth not doing what you were created to do. And so we've got to watch our words. So Colossians 4:6, the King James Version says this. It says, let your speech be always with grace, seasoned with salt, that you may know how you ought to answer every man. The New American Standard Bible says how you should respond one to another. And so we've got to watch what we say. We've got to learn getting back to controlling your emotions, and your emotions not controlling you. You've got to be able to tame your tongue. And so listen, the tongue, although it's a very small muscle, it is very powerful. It's so powerful that it can break a heart if you use the wrong words when using your tongue. See, the tongue is, let me tell you, it's here's a definition of the tongue. It says it's a muscular organ that manipulates food for mastication or chewing and swallowing. The tongue serves as a natural means to clean teeth, enables speech in humans and vocalizations in animals. Here's this thing about this tongue. It can lie. I'm going to say it again. It can lie, but it also has the ability to tell the truth. It's small, again, but it's strong enough to break a heart. It can choke the life out of you. You know, if you've ever experienced someone having a seizure, the first thing that one does is they run to get a spoon to hold the tongue so that the tongue does not roll back and choke the life out of you. And so although, you know, you can taste with the tongue, it's a sensor, but we've got to remember this, that it's powerful enough to break a heart. So you have got to watch your words. You've heard me say this before. Think before you speak. Is it true? Is it helpful? Is it inspiring? Is it needed? Is it necessary? Is it kind? And if you can't answer yes to all five of those statements, then you should not say anything. Remember, we are here to be the seasoning of the earth. So everything that comes out of our mouths should be pleasing. It should be soothing. Listen, Proverbs 21:3 says this, "Watch your tongue and keep your mouth shut, and you will stay out of trouble." Proverbs 21:23, the New Living Translation. So you can go back and look at that again. Watch your tongue and keep your mouth shut, and you will stay out of trouble. So somebody say, wherever you are, say, I've got to learn to pass the salt and tame my tongue. And so this is where I'm going to stop today, because we're going to be on this all week. I'm going to just give you just that little bit to meditate, to medicate on this morning. Pass the salt and tame your tongue, because your tongue, you should be using your mouth to edify, to uplift, to soothe, to encourage. You are here placed on earth to sprinkle God flavors, peace, love, joy, meekness, self-control, faithfulness. And the word says this, that if you are not doing that, then you've lost your flavor. You've lost what God needs you to do. You've lost your usefulness and might as well be thrown in the garbage. No one wants to be thrown in the garbage. So what are we going to do today? We're going to watch our words, as the little people say, watch your words. Pass the salt and tame your tongue. That is your daily dosage for today. We will definitely pick this up on tomorrow, because speaking life, saying the right thing, is also a part of this being addicted to the abundant life. I've got to watch my words. If you have not already subscribed to the YouTube channel, please do so. There you can find all of your dosages in one place. Follow me on social media platforms, God Wants Me Whole. Visit the website, GodWantsMeWhole.org. You know how we do this thing. Say, God wants me whole, and I am getting whole by the minute. Again, I'm Regina Banks, your GPS to wholeness. Don't forget December 18th. It is the gathering of hearts. I am so excited about it. And I received an email. Someone wanted to know, Pastor Regina, if I already know you, should I still come to the meet and greet? Absolutely, because I still want to see your face again, and you've got to meet the rest of Heartbeat Nation. Then the other question was this, will you be giving a live dosage? Absolutely. I'll be giving a live dosage that will not be recorded. It will not be posted up on any social media platform. So you want to be in the house to hear what God has to say. And he's already given it to me. I've been meditating on it now for about 2 weeks. So you have got to be in the house. Make sure you get your ticket at GodWantsMeWhole.org/conference. I love you guys a bunch, and I will see you tomorrow morning right back here at 7:30 a.m. Enjoy your day, pass the salt, and tame your tongue.